pag ang bata nang hingi ng pera sa magulang para sa school project or school fee, dapat
Hello Pilipinas! Ang video natin ay ang tatlong congressistang nag-question sa confidential fund ni VP Sara Duterte OOVP. Dahil sa sobrang laki at mabilis na nagastos, di umano. Or questionable, kaya panoorin natin kayo. Tama ba ginawa nila o mali?
Pinupuntiriya yung mga supplier and contractor. What we are after, Mr. Chairman, is the amount, the huge amount that is what spent for 11 days. And this is something extraordinary. Hindi naman po siya ganong kasimple that 40 million will be spent on medical and food aid, 11 days. Tapos yung supplies, 35 million for 11 days. Purchase of information, 14 million for 11 days. And ito pa, yung lastly, yung payment of incentives on traveling relative to the confidential operations. How does it work? Paano nagbabayad ng incentives or traveling? Can you kindly explain it to us? Because we spent 10 million in 11 days. Ano nakita mo doon? So, binigay sa iyo yung 35 million na purchase ng goods for 11 days. Siyempre, nakita mo, 35 million, 11 days. Wow! Ang bigat nito, 35 million, 11 days. Sino yung nag-supply nitong mga supply na to? Di ba? Yan ang trabaho mo eh. So, yes. Sino yung mga supplier?
Mr. Chair, kasi...
Sino yung mga supplier na nakita mo?
Sa merits na po kasi...
Oh my goodness.
Ang point po ni Congressman Dan Fernandez, hindi ka ba nagtaka? Yun po yung puntong gusto, yun po yung gusto niyang ipunto. Hindi po ba kayo nagtaka na nagkaroon ng purchase na worth 35 million in 11 days? Tama po ba 'yon?
Yes, oo. 35 million ako naman, kahit ako mayor ako eh. 'Di ba nakita ko, nag-purchase ako ng ganito 35 million in 11 days. Magugulat ako. Ano-ano ba 'to? So ikaw, bilang ikaw yung parang COA, nakikita mo yan, nakita mo 35 million in 11 days, supplies. Sino supplier nito? Di ba? Hindi maapekto ng merit nito, tinatanong ko lang kung sino yung supplier. Now, kung binigay nila yung supply, binayaran nila, at nakita natin above board, so what's the problem? Okay. But unfortunately, magugulat ka 11 days, 35 million for... purchase of supplies. Kaya tinatanong ko lamang, sino yung supplier? If you were going to compute 14 million divided mo sa 11, that is 1.2 million for the information that wanted to be purchased by the Office of the Vice President and was approved by the COA. And that worries me a lot, no? If this information entails, siguro kung mga 4 months yan or in 1 year yan, acceptable yan, but in a day? 1.2?
And if
purchase of information a day?
Pwede po bang isang tanong lang?
Yes, sir.
Yung po bang 14 million na yun ng information, sa isang tao lang po ba yun o maraming tao po yun?
Mr. Chair, hindi naman po yun sa isang tao lang.
Okay. Just to big, ilan pong tao? Kung alam lang po ninyo.
I don't have the information right
at
now.
At kung magkakaano po kada tao ang binigay para po sa purchase of information na yun? At kung saan po mga area?
Mr. Chair, details na po siya ng audit. So, you could, we could answer through if we are duly issued po sa PINA Ducesteco.
Is there any...
Secondly, Mr. Chairman, this is the payment of reward. Sa payment of reward, you utilize 10 million. The Office of the Vice President utilized 10 million. And this was spent for 11 days. So almost a million a day for the reward, payment of reward, cash. Cash. Same thing, COA. How this 10 million was utilized daily by the Office of the Vice President? Can you kindly educate me on how this happened? A million a day for payment of cash reward, was there any news about the cash reward that was given by the Office of the Vice President to any individuals for that matter pertaining to this payment of reward in cash by the Office of the Vice President? Purchase of supplies which cost us 35 million for 11 days. Madam Gloria. Purchase of supplies. Ano-ano po ba itong mga supplies na to? Ito na po ba yung mga chairs, tables, desktop?
Pag ang bata nang hingi ng pera sa magulang para sa school project or school fee, dapat mag-explain. Hindi binibigyan pag di nagpapaliwanag. Pag may natanggap, dapat may resibo para patunayan paano gumastos. Obligasyong magpaliwanag. Kapag student council o sanggunian ang kabataan, dumadaan sa butas ng karayom para magkapondo. Kahit short manifestation, as we did approve the motion to include the budget debates for the OVP sa September 24 session po natin. Mr. Speaker, we actually waited for 17 hours since 10 a.m. of September 23 up until mag-aalas 3 na po ngayon, September 24. We would like to state for the record ang naging consistent po na track record ng Office of the Vice President sa past hearings kung saan ninais na talakayin ang paggastos ng OVP sa pondo ng bayan. Mr. Speaker, sa unang salang sa Committee on Appropriations, naging evasive po ang nakaupong Vice Presidente at hindi sinasagot ng tuwira ng ating mga tanong. Sa pangalawang hearing ng Committee on Appropriations, hindi rin po siya nagpakita. Sa isang hearing ng Committee on Good Government and Public Accountability, siya ay tumanggi na mag-oath at umalis, tila ba ay nag-walk out sa hearing. Mr. Speaker, pag ang bata nang hingi ng pera sa magulang para sa school project or school fee, dapat mag-explain. Hindi binibigyan pag di nagpapaliwanag. Pag may natanggap, dapat may resibo para patunayan paano gumastos. Obligasyong magpaliwanag. Kapag student council o sanggunian ang kabataan, dumadaan sa butas ng karayom para magkapondo. Kahit ang ganda ng plano, di tiyak na mapopondohan. Pero kapag sitting vice president, pag nagpropose ng budget mula sa kaban ng bayan, para ang gustong iparamdam sa mga Pilipino ay, bahala na kayo kung ibibigay nyo o hindi ang hinihingi ko. Pero pag ayaw nyo ibigay, masama kayo. Mr. Speaker, the OVP has continued to characterize the questions of the Filipino people regarding their past questionable expenditures as political attacks and has not taken questions seriously. Mr. Speaker, to end, this is a clear betrayal of public trust as every elected official is accountable to the electorate and thus is obliged to answer any question that concerns public interest. Salamat, Mr. Speaker.
And you did not open the envelope because you feel so uncomfortable. Do you confirm?
Yes.
And then recently you made mention na it was only once that I had this case with the ombudsman. Do you confirm?
Yes, ma'am.
And you also made mention that you wish to protect yourself. Do you confirm?
Yes.
And the reason, ma'am, is because you believe that that envelope is a bribe. Do you agree with me? Because otherwise, you will not appreciate the job as difficult. You will not uncomfortable opening what you believe is allowance. You will not be thinking about the ombudsman case. You will not be thinking about protecting yourself. The reason why you are considering all these concerns is because you believe that the envelope is a bribe. Do you agree? Yes or no, ma'am?
It's kind of a harsh word to use, bribe, because if...
Or should I say, mommy, it is a means to influence your decision being the hope?
It could be.
You said yes to that? You said it could be.
Could be.
I wish to manifest, Mr. Chair, that on the story, on the narration of the resource speaker about this envelope, she received and she refused to open until the same is donated from February 2023 to September 2023 is a means actually to influence the decision of our resource speaker being the one who approved all the decision of the BAC in behalf of the DepEd Secretary. Tama po ba, ma'am?
There was only one instance that I could recall na ano, but there was no one spoke to me about Well, there was an instance where I tried to let a bidding lapse, but I ended up signing it because there was a protest. I'm not comfortable discussing it.
But I wish to state for the record, Mr. Chair, that with the narration of our resource speaker, she earlier manifested that she believes that those envelopes are means to influence her decision as hope.